Okay, so with another day here, we're back to coding, and not sure how long I'm going to keep this up of making videos every day. After all, I do have a couple exams this week and a couple final projects to do. After that, I am open until May the 15th until my classes start again, but we'll see how we go with making videos daily. Today, I'm going to tackle something I've been avoiding for a while. MFFS has been a mod we took over and started updating. Originally, I wasn't planning on doing this. I was planning on making my own force field system and doing everything with it. That's the reason why MFFS is called MFFS Classic, is there is a possibility we may make a new version of it, just like we did with ICBM. It's still on the drawing board. I'm still not sure where I'm heading with it. I have showed theoretical stuff of what we're going to do, like doing massive force field multi-block systems and stuff like that. But for today, that's not important. Today, we're going to go over the mod and review its functionality and see what needs fixed. I have been getting bug reports, I've been getting various things of where people have been complaining that the mod isn't functional. Before we actually launch Minecraft, I'm actually going to go set up the Minecraft 2 to actually run MFFS. And you know what we're going to do? No, actually, we'll just attach it. I was about to think we could just toss up and make a new spin-off real quick. That way I can test MFFS by itself. But we'll just attach MFFS to this. So I gotta go find it in my workspace here. Okay, there it is. I believe that's all I need is to add this. I don't think I need anything else. Yeah, it looks like because we have Volts Engine here, and MFFS should trigger Volts Engine to load all of its contents, so we don't need to do anything special. We'll go ahead and launch debug on the second client. And while we're doing that, I'm going to go ahead and start skimming through the main mod class. I haven't touched MFS in a while. I started on an update for it, then I ended up letting somebody else do an update on it. Because we got to a point, we were getting things functional, but they weren't quite stable. And this guy, Poopsicle, had updated the mod completely. So we're like, you know what? Just go use your version. Your version functions. It is missing some content, but it functions. And I just threw it at him and, like, hey, go for it. So now we need to make sure that all of his content is fully functional now. Okay, so he's still using the old packet system, so that will need to be migrated. This is where I'm going to need to make a special packet handler for him because he has a lot of various things going on here. So yeah, old packet system. He's still probably using the old setting system. No, he ported it over to utilize just the vanilla version. We used to have an old setting system where you annotated all the fields that you wanted it to be used. We may reintroduce that again. I shut it off as kind of a worthless endeavor to do annotation configurations, but I'm starting to revisit the ideal of it because I started doing it with my block.json. If I do it there, then I might as well start looking at doing it other places because it doesn't add too much overhead to the load time. But it saves us developers a tremendous amount of work, and that's really important. His mod looks pretty, class looks pretty good. He's got his IDs here, versions, the name of the mod. He's utilizing the system correctly, so he's telling it where stuff should be. The config folder should technically be inside the VE folder. Let me go up a folder real quick and see how we're looking at this. Yeah, he's just straight out using the config path. Git class contains. Are we inside of the build broken? No, we're in MFFS package. So that means his path is going to be MFFS than his mod thing. That actually does need to be fixed. All of our mods should utilize the same folder. Not sure if we'll migrate that or not right now. It's not too big of an issue. The network system does need to be changed. Other than that, he is utilizing everything else correctly. He is not registering his I mean, he's registering his items, but he's not storing them. He's storing the blocks. And he is utilizing our new block item registry system. So how it works is abstract mod actually specify what gets loaded in what order. So in here, we load handlers, blocks, items, and then we claim content from the JSON system. So as you see, handlers, blocks, items, and there's entities down here. Entities are loaded in the init phase. You can load them in any phase you want. There's no rules really on it. I do init because in case the entities need access to items and blocks, which they really shouldn't. And then recipes are always last because you want to have access to almost all the mods when you load your recipes. And then there's a load complete event too. This isn't used by most mods though. Yeah, that works. And we're gonna probably be rolling out a new system for this as well because what I was looking at is the fact that in order for us to use the system, we have to do stuff like this. Like we have to initialize our proxies, we have to do this, we have to call super. Super runs all of our stuff. What if I could just have the engine do all this for us? I don't think the systems care how things behave. And yeah. And I can work around Forge and make Forge believe what mod is loaded. We'll have to toy with that though. Okay, so we're back to our test world. Last time we were in here, we were testing the rocket launcher. Now we're going to test the force field. So let me clear my inventory. Get everything out of there. I barely remember how to use this, so apologies if this is not very good. This is not a tutorial, by the way. This is literally a coverage of functionality. So we need the projector, courier driver. These really need better textures. Interdiction matrix. I don't remember what this is, but its texture doesn't look right. I'm not familiar with what this thing is. I think it removes items from your inventory is how this is supposed to function. And then the biometrics textures don't look right either. At least on the item they don't. They look okay-ish from here. This entire block needs to actually be redone. That'll be something that'll be handled. Of course, we're still using our old screen here. I made a new one for the newer version of FFS. I may port it over to the classic. Well, these items need to be fixed. We have quite a few things that need to be adjusted. Yeah, let's find a little flatter spot. Okay, so we got this. Got a capacitor. And let's actually move our capacitor back here. I don't want to get the power source stuck inside of the force field. I've done that a few times. It's retarded. So we got these all up. This is going to need power. Okay, I'm going to need to pick this back up, put this down, put this here. Okay. Then I need glowstone. Okay, you're not supposed to max it out. You're supposed to set it to infinite. Are we running as dev? Okay, I think we are. Although this is being stupid. Yeah, we're in development mode. Okay. Maybe it's glowstone I need to use. Ah, it's set to infinite. What I was trying to do is set this to infinite so that way I didn't have to do anything. It would be work. And then set the connection side to true, and we place this down. I believe this needs a redstone torch of some kind. Cool. We're producing power. Let's set our frequency to 1. And set our frequency to 1 on here. Okay. Oh, cool. The animation still works. And we'll set this to 1. But we need to configure this bad boy. So, trying to remember how to do this. A lot of these modulars need to be renamed. Textures probably need to be updated. I don't think anybody's going to care if we actually redo textures for this mod. Oh, that's a correlation driver. I need this thing. Okay, So this needs this in the middle. That's going to give us a cube. Cool, the animation still works properly. Then we need scale modulars. I need translation. This is the reason why I also need to redo the inventory system, is all of the scale stuff should be up next to each other. All the hostile stuff should be in the bottom. All of the sizes should be in the middle. Like, things should be sorted. If you go to the ICBM tab, I have intentionally... Oh, actually, I don't have the ICBM tab. But the ICBM mod, all of its stuff is intentionally sorted. So the order it's in, it will always be the same order, and it actually makes it real easy. You know, I could have just used the infinite power card for this, but oh well. So I want to go up by, like, a couple blocks here. Then we'll scale one in every direction. And see what that gives me. I don't seem to be getting anything here. Should be getting something of size 1. Is it not producing enough power? That might actually be the case. Capacity modulars. And yeah, I'll get a capacity modular here too. There should be an energy transfer modular. Like, I know this one increases the capacity, but there should be another one that increases the transfer speed. Well, the thought process is it might just be a scalar transition modular. So anyway, it might how it works. So we're gonna... Okay, those do fit in there. But we need to upgrade this guy. Okay, so it's still doing 5 kiloliters a tick. Neither of these seem to be affecting it, so we're going to toss all these in my inventory. It's one of the reasons why I've been avoiding working on this mod. Oh, this might be it. Oh yeah, that was it. So it's called a speed modulator, is how it works. Increase the speed of devices. The tooltips need to be fixed. Aha! We got our field. It's not where I wanted it to be, though. Okay, you're north. That's why you're not where I want you to be. Oi, where'd you go? Turn it off real quick and let it recharge. Okay, up and down her are inverted. Okay, that's awesome. That's a bug. It's an easy one to probably fix too. This is one of the reasons why I don't like this system, is these are confusing. You have to hover over them to really know what they are. And then even then, they don't seem to be correct. The system I've designed to replace it is just scroll bars, and that's what we're going to move to. I don't care what people complain about, that's what is going to happen. But we need to go hunt down wherever... Oh man, there's no... there's literally no... anything in here. Of course, Poopsicle's got his name on top of everything, even though he shouldn't have his name on it. So a lot of these should be Calclavia's names. He must have had to reverse engineer some code. Yeah, none of this stuff is named properly. These should be container biometric, not biometric container. Some of these other ones are okay. So we're looking for the tile. So I believe it's tile filled matrix. Oh man, documentation is lacking. Lacking really bad. Okay, so this is probably the method that's wrong. No, actually, these are just inverted. So this is translation. Scale is probably inverted too, and we'll check it in a second. Okay, so if I remove this and put this in here. Okay, yeah. That's fixed now. Let's look at scale real quick. So, Y scale seems to be solely affected by the up direction. That could be fixed. And how's this method function? Okay, this just gives me. Oh no, that gives me all the slots. Okay. We're going to adjust this. This is not too big of an issue, but I can improve the functionality. So we go here and we set this to down direction, and that will make sure that both those slots are used. And of course, I just redid the entire thing. I'm not quite sure what's going on here. So there's get orientation. There's probably some behavior going on that I'm gonna have to take into account here later. But this should allow me to split the scaling stacks between both slots and get a better effect. So right now, yeah, I need to up the translation a little bit here. So I want to be above me so I don't put the force through my head. And if I put a scale into that modular. Actually, I think it already worked. If I take a scale out, it got smaller. So right now we've got a weirdly shaped cube, pretty much. One of the scales is not working. Like the scale this way is not doing its job. Okay, because we're missing a scale modular. Oh no, wait, the scale modulars combine each other, don't they? Actually, no, this is. Come on, let me split the stack. Okay, there we go. We got the correct size cube, so we get a 3x3. Good for testing. And we put another one in each one of these. We should get a 5x5. That's a translation. Throw the translations over here. Okay, now we just need to do up. Cool. Ish, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is not scaling properly. So we got scale. We got two scales in basically every direction right now. And yet, it's not giving us the correct results. Now this made it even worse because now we're only scaling one in each direction. Even though we got two scale modulars there. Okay. So something's broken here. There's an omnidirectional scale factor, which is probably these slots over here. How's this work? That's some pretty straightforward code, actually. Yeah, this is it's pretty straightforward code, so there's nothing complicated about it. I don't know why this isn't being fed up into this up here, but oh well. So this should work. Put a debug line here real quick though, to figure out what's up. Hit play on this because I don't want to deal with it. We'll put it back in. Okay. Okay, we have two on the Z, two on the X. Two on that. Two on the Y. So for some reason down didn't return any scale modulars because we got two both times. When we look at this, yeah, we have two in every direction, so what's up? We shouldn't shouldn't be getting basically a little bit of everything here, so there's something missing here. So apparently the force field is facing in the west direction, which doesn't really matter. Although we are set to absolute, so it will change the orientation. Not by a significant amount, though. Technically, these should not be in absolute by default. But it doesn't matter too much. But this has changed the behavior somehow. Okay, parameter.original slot directions.length return etc. If not, return slot directions, which means slot directions is being set somewhere or it's a static. Oh, it's a static, okay. So and I didn't want to close that. So let's see. A lot of really messy code in here. So this code and this code should literally be identical to each other, but they're not. This is returning two scale modulars. We've got two, 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 two. There's two there. We don't got anything in the down direction, which I guess makes sense. Yeah, we don't have anything in the down direction. But then we're getting a filled, which is not actually scaled correctly. So we're going to fill that. Acts like it's only scaled in one. Well, actually, no, that makes sense. It actually does. This is what I get for not understanding how the mod works properly. Okay, so the changes I just made should have made it scale. What the? One, two, three. Now we're scaled three in each direction. Okay. Blender. Close my door real quick. Be cool if I get some warning on that. Okay. So Y scale position plus orientation direction gets me my actual scale. The problem is the Y scale is ending up making this a lot larger than it should be. So we should be getting a 5x5 is what we should be getting. Instead, we're getting 4. That's probably why it only scales with one direction. Let me reset this real quick. Oh, what just happened there? I don't know, but it's deciding it wants to be annoying. Okay, that should be 2 in every direction. Yet we're still getting this weird, only wants to go 1 in each direction here. So, huh. So what we could do is just times this by 2. And see what happens. That does give us a 5x5, actually. Cool. So you get that nice even scale. But then why, when we go to put it in the south, and it doesn't work properly. Because that would have given us 4. Either way, we would have got the result of 4. And we're back to getting that weird, only wants to go in one or the other direction. Okay, so we're gonna do, pull this out, put a debug line here, put this back in. Okay, so, oh, there's a negative scale. Either way, we're going to take a look at this. We still got 2. So even though I know, well, actually, did we put slots back in? No, we didn't. We didn't put down slot. So we don't need this line. That much I've figured out, because it's handled down here. So we're going to follow it out and see if that is actually called. And I don't really want to care. Oh my god, how many slots do you have? How do I know there's a way to exit out of this. Thank you. Okay, projector. Okay, so it goes from positive, so it goes from negative to positive, so yeah, we just wanna handle things a certain way. Okay. Cube handles the actual scaling. He's still got vector 3D in here that needs to be transitioned to pause. Not sure if I want to do that today or not. Where were we at? We're in this class. There we go. Kill my debug line. Make sure I reload. So we just need to throw some stuff in the down slot. Did we get a 5x5? No, we don't get a 5x5. So there's still some kind of... Oh no, we do get a 5x5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, sweet. Okay, so there wasn't an issue. This does work. So that's not a problem. And we document what our discovery, so. Oh, come on. Apparently, I'm having trouble spelling some of the words today. Okay. So we put those notes there. That way, we know what's going on, is pretty much the reason why we're doing that. I'm going to assume a lot of these other parts are actually working properly. I don't have time to test everything, and unit testing would be the more preferable way to test all the functionality here. I mean, it all looks good. Trying to think of like how we're going to test the rest of the modules. I mean, we know at least these guys are working properly. Even though I've been told the equalization and stuff on them is not precise, which it's okay. I don't really care. So now we just need to toy around with a few other things. So let's get the biometric system working. Frequency one. I don't remember how to make biometric cards. We'll test with a friendly for modular first. So this goes in here. Oh, no, it goes here. Wow, that is confusing. That's not gonna work. We need grass. The reason I'm doing this is we're gonna create a little spawn box to see what we can kill with this. That should work, just to be sure we'll put a little edging on it. That way we've got a pretty easy to use little box to throw stuff in. We'll probably implement a few features here while we're at it as well. I know I need to get EMPs working again, although EMPs should mess up the power system. The problem is if you... The field is large enough, it won't hit the power core, so I gotta weaken the field instead. It's a feature that's been added and removed a lot, because every time we go and fuck with MFFS, we have to kind of figure out what we're doing, and then most of the time it just results in removal functionality. So we want a torch down here. Okay, and then we need to click that off. Okay, that'll work. Now we need to throw some piggies in here. Make some bacon. Why you no die? Probably need, I need to move the fill down one. That is totally a bug. It just deleted blocks.
Okay, so where in the hell does that even handle that? Okay, so filled matrix is actually shared by two different devices, so it's not going to be the filled matrix. It's going to be the force field projector. Oh, we need to like reformat all of the code in here. I might be just... You know what, I can do this real quick. So first we're going to do... We're going to synchronize what we have before we do the whole mess of messies. And words are complex. If I start slurring my words are becoming incoherent, I apologize. It just happens. Okay. What bug did we correct? We corrected something. Okay, we'll do that. So that will synchronize. And then what we're going to do is there should be a way to format all of the code in one go. There's also a way to turn Lombok on, but I'm not going to deal with that right now. Here, reformat code. Clips has the same feature, in case anybody's interested too. Yeah, by the way, our standards is next line, not same line. And for those who are going to argue, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't care what the code is set up as. The reason we use next line is that's just what we use. Anyways, we got to figure out where in here that we mess up. It's most likely project filled. Why is this using streams? Okay, so we filter and we make sure that the X does not equal a projector and that we can replace. Then we filter that the chunk is loaded. Then we filter by our limit of how many we can do. So the can replace check is most likely what's broken. Hey, Dima's name is in here. That's actually not why that's there, but hilarious, nonetheless. And there's a, yeah. This needs to be greater than equal than zero. That's what that needs to be. It's replaceable. Get modular count. This is going to be one of those really shitty debug sessions because I'm going to have to cycle through a couple for loops. Click. Okay. So we get our location. Cool. We go down and... Oh, because I need to do this. Reload. Blarg, 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 blarg. Probably the disintegration modular check is broken. There we go. Okay, hit play. Okay. Disintegration modular equals zero. So this needs to be greater than zero. What I'm looking for, by the way, is an isReplaceable check. And go find this. Okay, material is replaceable. Set replaceable, okay. So what the reason I was looking for that is this whole entire piece of shit here needs to go away. Because there's a broken loop here, and that's what I was looking for. The reason why, there's so many things wrong with these checks, and I hate when they look like this. So, actually, you know what? That check was good. So I'm going to go if dmod equals 0, that's weird to say. We're going to rename that in a second. Return blockness is greater than. The reason we're doing this is just readability real quick. We want to grab this part. Move this section. Liquids are technically replaceable. Air is replaceable. So we want to get rid of that. We want to do a whole thing here where we just ignore force field blocks. Okay. This technically should be something cached in the machine itself. It should not be recalculated every tick. So we'll do this. To do cache, do not recalc each tick. The rest of this should work. And we're going to say that the force field can kill replaceable blocks by default. So it'll kill crops, kill all your stupid stuff. So that'll change a little bit of logic about the machine for those who are familiar with how this works. I don't really care. The focus is to make this thing functional. Okay, that fixed it. Did we commit? Yeah, we committed when we refactored everything. And I need to do this. VE remove living 1000. Goodbye, piggies. Okay. Anti-friendly is not working. Okay, so we're gonna have to figure out where that works at. Okay. Oh god. He's using an iMessage system. Not horrible, but man. That definitely needs to be fixed. Okay, so this calls project force field. Every 10 ticks. This is threaded. Not sure why this is threaded, because it won't really do anything. Should be the whatever thread is running that could possibly conflict with this should have been the one synchronizing, not this tile. Unless project force field can be called from a thread. So we're looking for where this modular is at. Okay, module requires tick true. Okay, here's an on project thing, so it requires tick. Probably need to reprogram this to be a little different. So then that means we need to go find the anti-friendly modular. And I need to read this. So will cause interdiction make okay, so what we need. So items, modulars, interdiction, anti-friendly. It's not even detecting it. Okay. So this code looks like it should run, because if it's not, if since it's an MPC, or actually, you know what? That's the problem right there. Oh no, wait, here we go. If it's an instance MPC or not a monster, so that works. It does shock. Yeah, it pretty much kills everything in one hit. That's pretty dumb. Okay, maybe there's something wrong with, it's not detecting it? Is that the, maybe that's not even the slot it goes in? You know what, that might actually be what's wrong. Does it go in here? No. Maybe I need this interdiction matrix, because what are these? These are, yeah, interdiction matrix, okay. Go in here. Ooh, that seems to be working. Frequency one. Okay. Seems to be doing something. Are you guys dying? No, you're not dying yet. You're not doing squat. Okay. Still not dying. I mean, it acts like it's functioning properly. But maybe this needs to be next to the force field. Still not dead. Still not dead. I'm gonna up the size of this just a little bit. Okay. Still not dead. Okay, we gotta figure out how this runs. So maybe the interdiction matrix doesn't work. That actually might be the case. Oh, wow. We have a biometric identifier? I didn't remember placing one. I guess I might have placed one. Okay, weather size and range. Get living entities. It's detected not a single damn entity. The reasoning for this is this actually should not be this. It should be entity. Because you want to be able to fuck up other things other than that. The sentry guns, for example, are not living. On defend. Okay. So what we're going to do is hit play, and I'm going to re-edit some code here, which means I got to close the game. Okay, come on. Quit doing that. Hit play. That scans per tick, so at least we figured out where the code is. But I want to change up the API real quick, because I want to change this to this. Nope, cancel. That's not what I wanted to do. Place this. I'm going to have to edit some code here. This actually won't change anything technically. The only thing this will do is this will allow us to program more complicated systems in the future, which is the whole reason why I'm doing it. We're just going to copy the whole header here. Close others. Unable to find. Did I accidentally delete something? No. Oh, no. Yeah, I did. Phone just did its thing. Wonder what it's doing. Let's check it out. And just a Facebook notification. Why are all these parameters named different? There's almost no consistency between these. They're all theoretically coded by the same exact person, too. Okay, that's Calcladria for you. He's less consistent than I am. It's ironically the reason we got to work together so well. Is that we weren't exactly consistent, but at the same time, because of that, we actually managed to coexist without too much of an issue. At least that's my theory on the situation. The reality of it is that I think we just kind of tolerated each other. Because we always got frustrated that the other was doing something retarded.
at least in our opinions. That's the thing. Everybody has a different coding style, and unfortunately, I didn't like Cal Calabi's coding style. He did not like mine. He also didn't like the fact that I didn't keep up with any kind of time schedule. I still don't keep up with time schedules. They're not something that are easy to do. Okay. So we need to toy around with some things here. We need to rename some variables. Warning, range, action, range. There's range. There's our entities. There's our modulars. So it looks like when it calls get modular stacks, it literally grabs everything. So we're gonna run again. And where are we at? Wait, 56 minutes. So we might cut this video after doing this, and then I'll make another video here later after I get some breakfast. Because right now, tea and a cup of yogurt is not food. I'm still working my way down the tea. This needs to be renamed a player. Is access granted? It's probably where that bug is. Somebody reported that the biometric system isn't working. Probably isn't working because it probably isn't checking the username properly. These should be UUID systems, but they're not upgraded. This is the reason why I noted in a bug report, whoever found that issue, that the whole permission system needs to be overhauled. It is still more than likely using my old permission system because I recoded the MFFS permission system way back for CalcLawView because I'm like, you know what, whatever you're using Calc is not enough. And unfortunately, it probably means the system is either utilizing my old code or it's not using it at all. Seeing as it is using a permission node enum system, it probably is using my older code, but we'll have to toy with it. I'd like to get it ported over the new system, because if we get the new system online, that means the same code that runs the sentry guns is the same code that runs your MFFS system. So if you auth somebody on your sentry grid, you can auth them on your force fields at the same time. This will eventually tie back into a global permission system where you go, okay, I've got group A. Group A has access to the whole facility marked as A. That'll then prevent sentry guns from killing them and everything else. But then the group A can't get into group B's area. And group B can go into A, but can't go into B. It'll be like a whole type of permission system, and you'd be able to like lock certain areas down and everything. It'll be a whole elaborate thing. Like I've imagined the whole system out. Okay, you guys are still alive, which means I didn't fix anything. Then again, I didn't really change anything. Okay, biometric identifier's on. Are you linked to frequency one? Yeah, you're good. You're good. Oh, you are near the scanning range. You are near the scanning range. You know what's dumb about this, though? As you see where I'm at, I am only one block outside of that. That means the range is messed up. Warning range is the maximum of the action and warning range. Okay. Get entities within axis. Axis equals get bounding blocks plus one in each direction. This is actually not correct. Nobody's fault why this isn't correct either. It's just the whole I hate the Minecraft system type of thing going on. Yeah, so what we're going to do is we're going to make an axis bounding box that is literally the size of zero at the point of the center of the tile. Then when you expand it by the range, it will expand it properly in all directions, and you'll match the range. Okay, that's fixed. See, it won't warn me when I'm here. But if somehow I got within inside the field, which is an impossibility, by the way, it would warn me. Can I actually make a lever on the inside here? We probably can pull that off. Let me toy with a few things here. Always like messing with redstone. It's always awesome. I gotta say, if Minecraft never had redstone, it probably would have never been as popular as it ever was. Redstone is one of the many things that has made the game as good as it is. Okay, I probably need to... Will this connect? It does not connect. That is actually an easy to fix problem. What we're going to do is we're going to actually do this. That way I can put a lever here. And my fingers are tingling. Ah. Though I like to play with redstone, by the way, I am not actually very good at the whole redstone thing. Yeah. Okay, that'll work. That'll give me my inverted state system. Now we just need to set this up so it's in an off state by default. I wonder if we toggle it in here, will it invert? No, that won't do anything. Okay. So that means I need to introduce one more thing. So we need to move this back so I can create an inverter. So we need that, put that there. Then we put this here, do this, do that, okay. It lets me turn the field on to the outside. And that lets me then, if I'm up here, and I put a thing on here, where's that lever go? It goes right here. Field's on. Cool. I'm not getting any warnings, so I may have broke the range. Action range is zero. Why is action range zero? Probably because there's no actions. Okay. I wanted to get the stupid system. So axis equals this. And we'll put axis down here. Actually, this is going to have to go down here. Okay, the reason I'm doing that is I need to get everything. This will get entities, inbox, and get modulars. To be honest, we should calculate the modulars first, and if you have no modulars, we shouldn't be grabbing the entities, because this is somewhat of a slow thing. This is a fast thing. And we can actually invert these really quick. And we can go, if modulars... doesn't equal null, and modulars.size is greater than zero. And we can somewhere down here put this, and then reload. And that'll prevent this from ticking if we don't have modulars. So that means I want to put you down here and hit play. Okay. So we do have a modular, and if we check our modulars, that is the anti-friendly modular. What is our size? We want to look at our axis box. Okay, our size on our axis box looks appropriate. I'm not getting any warnings though, but that's because I don't have any system, I guess. I don't know, there's a word for it. I don't know why it was warning me in the first place.
I just came to the conclusion of something here. You see how this is pulling X, Y, and Z? It's pulling X and Y, Z of the interdiction matrix. So we're going to pop this off real quick. I'm going to exit the force field. I'm going to turn it back on. Yeah. Yeah, that's retarded. Okay. So, that's the reason I don't like the whole force field system. It's all this stuff isn't set up right, and I don't know if it should be one way or another. I've got no notes on the original designs. I've got no documentation to tell me how things are supposed to work. We're under the assumption that it should work a certain way, and the only confirmation I have is I can go watch other people's YouTube videos, or I can go read tutorials and stuff to tell me how to fix my own mod at this point. So I'm going to assume the interdiction matrix is designed to grab everybody inside of a force field. So we need to then grab the projection area of the force field. What is the range on these? Settings, config, interdiction, max range, plus. That gives me the thing is, maybe these are actually designed to be specific to a certain area? So what is the max range? Integer to max, wow. Okay, so you gotta scale the range of the interdiction matrix in order to get it up to a certain size. There's no translation system on the interdiction matrix. That means it's based on where you're standing. This means theoretically the interdiction matrix system is independent from the force field, but that doesn't make any sense. This is where I keep wondering, why can't I just stick this into this and have it work? It has an effect on the system. It doesn't seem to do anything though, so. So there's no effect on this. So we're gonna recode this all. And by recode, I'm going to leave this as part of this system. So the interdiction matrix is going to control this. But now the interdiction matrix is going to be based off of this force field size. So we want to get our projection. We want to get our projector, pretty much. Oh, my phone's charged. It's not important though. Why is this here and not somewhere else? Should be like up here. That's just stupid. I mean, if you don't want to put a documentation, don't put documentation. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna stop the game real quick. So I interdiction matrix. I don't care about these guys. Gonna go like this. I'm gonna hit build and see if that actually affects anything. If it just affects the interdiction matrix, then that means that stuff was unique to that interdiction matrix. If it doesn't, then there's an interesting thing here. So there's a matrix helper that grabs the find matrix. And you are used by the remote control. Okay. Yeah, both used by the remote control. Okay, so we want to put those methods back then. I'm going to fix this because I don't like next lines on this. None of this is documented at all. Just absolutely just clusterfuck. The reason I don't like working on other people's mods a lot is this is the whole process. You have to go and reverse engineer somebody's mod. You got to figure out what it's supposed to do. Then you got to figure out if it needs fixed. And it's one problem after another after another. This is going to be changed to a cube. And so is this. How this works is we'll get the cube of the matrix. Why is this called an entity? Tile equals equals our world object. Not really that useful, to be honest. What we want to do is we want to go cube range equals matrix dot get action range. And then we want to go cube, or we're going to go range dot contains. And then I believe we just want to go like this. Oh, shoot. Okay, luckily there is a XY check. And we just need to repeat this up here. Except I believe this is... What did this one want? This one wants also action range? So I'm going to reverse this real quick because I want to see what this one was originally. And they're both action ranges. So we'll restore what I just did. This will allow more flexibility because this allows a non-perfect box size. Right now these were set to ranges and we don't want ranges. I don't want any of this crap either. So I'm gonna go cube, cube, import class. Right now these are gonna return null because I don't really care about scale modulars, I don't care about stack sizes, I don't care about anything. These aren't important. Get amplifier. Action range divided by it, so it's just gonna be one. Control B, I want to find usage on this real quick. Tile field projector. You actually have a usage? Or is this like... Oh, you're just a global method. Okay. Hit Control B one more time. I want to see what the other one was. Tile modular acceptor. Yeah, I don't care. This is a one. Okay, so... This is a little flaky because I gotta get rid of this. That means I get rid of this. I then need to get my warning range, then my action range, then which one of these is larger I want to use. Actually, you know what? I don't care. So the warning range should always be larger than the action range. So that means we want to use our warning range for our detection. So get entities within. And I just want to pass in world. Okay, that'll do Unity class by default. We don't care about this part. They're within range. No, actually, we do want this. So we want to go action range dot is within. I'm probably gonna have to unit test the is within check. I don't know if it actually is functional. And then if not, so if else you're not within the action range, that means you're definitely within the warning range. So you want to print out a line saying you're about to get raped by the force field. Means we don't need distance. We just got to calculate the field now. Means we need to find our projection matrix. So we're gonna have a private tile projection, tile field projector. So projector. And what we want to do is if projector equals null. By the way, this could be 20, I don't know why that's that. This only scans once a second, so we're just gonna put this down here. Put this down here. Private static final int up tick rate is what we're gonna call this. Trying to get a little bit more consistent with this whole utilizing stuff like that. So projector equals null. We want to basically go all five sides looking for a projector. So I'm going to go for forge direction, direction. You know what we could do? We could get projectors. So an introduction matrix could run on multiple projectors. Actually, I got a better idea. So, forge direction, valid directions. Okay. Okay, now the interruption is over. So pause equals new. Pause this. Cast system tile entity just in case I add by position code to the projector matrix. Okay, so we want to get the tile entity. So how we get the tile entity is tile entity tile equals pause dot get tile entity world. We do need to add the direction of this direction. I'm going to go if tile is instance of projector. Or it's tile force field projector. Okay. Count plus plus projector equals tile. That's how this is going to work. And then we want to go. If count is greater than one, projector equals null, and we'll put a to-do flag here. That's not what I want. So I want const. I don't know how to spell the word. Whatever. Constant. I think it's how you spell the word. Whatever. Good enough. This should work. This gets our projector. Then when we go to scan, I'm going to pass in the projector for the moment.
because of the fact that I actually want the possibility that we might be able to do more than one projector. So we're going to pass in the projector here. And what we're going to do is we're going to do else. So it's going to take one tick for it to kick on, and then it's going to take another kick for it to not kick on. There's a couple other things I need to do with here, like prevent orphan chunk loading and other things. I think Italian actually does do that. World doesn't equal null. No, it actually does not. Screw it. I don't really care about orphan chunk loading at the moment. That's something I could do later. You know what? Passing the projector isn't going to help, so I don't care here. We have to put it down here. So we want to go if projector doesn't equal null, then we want to return projector dot get something. There's got to be a method in here to get the force field shape. There's not actually. We're gonna have to calculate it, and I hate to do that because that's gonna be like a per tick thing. Yeah, we'll have to calculate it. Each tick is just gonna be like slow. We're probably gonna fuck with the CPU. So this would be cube scale. What do we want? How do we get scale? Get scale. Oh, I gotta get negative scale and positive scale. That won't be too big of an issue. So this would be vector 3D neg scale equals projector. Projector dot get negative scale. Wish my fingertips would not be numb like this. It's only the one hand too. Probably slept on is what happened. So this gives me my scale. I do need to get my position, so vector 3 translation equals projector okay. From this I can construct my position pretty much. So we want to create a cube. And we've got our negative and positive, so this is our size. What are we looking at here? These are mutable. And if we look at here, these are calculated, so I don't have to worry about messing with them. So we want to go negative scale dot add translation. And then we want positive scale dot add translation. That'll work. We've got to turn both these into pauses though. So we want to go pause start equals new pause negative scale dot x, negative scale dot y, negative scale dot z. And we just got to repeat that with the endpoint. And this will be the pause scale. And when I transition this over to the position system rather than using the old vector system, I'll have to come through and redo this. The reason why is this add method technically does not make a new object. It returns the original. The way we can actually mitigate the amount of work required to do this is just doing something like this real quick. Because the position system is immutable, which means you can't change it. So when you call add on the position system, it returns a new object. The old system, which is the Vector 3D system, is mutable, and I might keep both systems, to be honest. I may just update the Vector 3D system and utilize it, as having a mutable system for things like force fields is actually really useful. Though, things like your position data should be immutable, so you can't change them. So that would kind of ruin the system anyways, but whatever. So new cube, start, dot end. This is actually going to go down to the below here, and we're just going to return empty cube. Okay, looks like somebody's actually trying to work on the MFFS system. Issues. Where'd this come from? Is this a mail? So I get this. This might just be an email. You know what? That is probably an email. Respond to that real quick. Won't take me long. My channel. There's a video on how to explain how to set up a Volts engine. I need to make a new one. Actually, I want to search my channel, not global, so. See if this is. Alright, hey everybody! Click yes. Then we'll add. After this is done, we're going to go ahead and. Okay, I took care of that. Well, we have video recording time. We're at 1:30, so I gotta hurry up and finish this up. So what we want to do? So we've got our action range. Then we want our warning range to be slightly larger than our action range. You know what? I might actually do is if you don't have a projector, the interdiction matrix will work as normal. So what we want to do, return our position pretty much. So we calculate the position right here. I do need to add 0.5 to that. Actually, I'm going to do this better. So this will be x coordinate plus 0.5, y coordinate plus 0.5, z coordinate plus 0.5. And we'll repeat this down here. Not in this spot, but specifically, we want to do it here. So go pause center point. And then we want to do new cube. So we actually want to get the range. So int range equals. What was it beforehand? So we got to open up source tree to figure out what the method call was beforehand. Looks like I've edited quite a few things too. So interdiction. I want tile interdiction. So the class I'm editing. Why don't I see? Oh, there it is. About to go on another rant blaming this for not running properly. Okay, so it's pretty much this line is what we want. I'm trying to think of how to get this. I can just copy it. So we're gonna do this really quick, put that there, and let me go fetch the other one. And then here's the action range. So we want to do this and put that right there. So the warning range is basically the number of warning modules you have plus the action range plus 3. And then the this is just scale modular based. So what we want to do is we just want to get we just copy the whole line here. So this works out pretty well. This does mean that up here we're going to have to recalculate this. So we want to grab the number. You know what, we're going to do this, and we're just going to do some substitution real quick. So we're going to grab this, put that there, put this here, int action range. And then we want the action range right here. And that'll work, because that'll give us pretty much how the default ranges are working. And what we're going to do with this is going to be center.subtract range. And this will be center.add. Oh, come on. Add and then range. So this will give us our basically what we had before. It'll make the interdiction matrix run. And then what we'll have up here is we'll get the pretty much the same result. So we want to... Actually, we don't need this. We want this. And what we're going to do is, I believe I can actually make this work. So put this up here. Put this here, okay. Put this here, and then we want to do get action range dot. Oh, I don't have an expand method. I have a scale method. We are going to make an expand method. I need one of these. I've been probably several spots been wanting to use one of these. So create method expand in cube. Okay, so this pretty much works by resetting the start and end points. So start equals min dot sub range, and then pause end equals max dot sub range, and then we return a new cube. So new cube start end. Did I mention, by the way, the cube is immutable as well? Well, sort of. You can change the start and end points in a cube, but it is designed to act like it is immutable. I think. Let me actually check. We can actually check this. There should be an add method here somewhere. Oh, no, it is mutable. Okay. We're gonna go cut that method real quick and move it up to the rest of things. Oh, there's, never mind, there's a crop the world method right there. We'll leave it there. So we want to set our size here. So set, and then we want start, end. And what does set do? Set returns void. So we're gonna come back to the bottom here, and we wanna return this. Get rid of that. Okay, that'll work. Really easy method. Gets our pretty much system going. Gonna hit build to see if this runs, and we should get the behavior we want. The only thing I need to do is up in the scan method. We want to go and projector equals null, or projector dot. There's got to be a method for this. So what I want to do is I want to know if we are within the projectors field. So if we're within the action area, we're within the action area. But the thing is, the projectors are not, or the force fields are not actually perfect in size. They can be tubes, they can be pyramids, and we want to reflect that. So there is a method for this. Or at least there should be. Okay, get force fields dot contains new vector 3D entity. To do unit test position. Okay, this should work in theory. And we're on debug, and then we'll call it this end of the video. It's probably one of the longer videos I'll ever upload, and I'll try to get time management a little better here. Feel the weirdest thing. Tips of my fingers on my left arm are basically numb. I've had this happen before. All I know is I get flex it long enough, it'll stop. It's basically a poor circulation issue is what's causing it. But I don't know an easy way to fix it. Probably just need to get something warm and stick it in my hand. But moving on, let's see what this tests. I need to program a visual projection of interdiction matrices, because this is just a really cheap trap, is what this is. So we're gonna put this up here. To do reprogram to have a visual effect, so this cannot be used as a trap. See what happens. So far, so good. No crashing. Warning, what? Oh. Okay, that needs to be fixed. Why are you not dead? Okay, something's broken. Okay, so. Oh, reload. Apparently, I changed something. Okay, you're an interdiction matrix. Why? Oh, wait. What am I missing here?
You know what? I don't actually want this to be the way it is. I think it just round errored me. Go like that. This actually means this code needs to run now. Okay, reload that. I think the dog just got thrown in my room. Okay. Okay, reload one more time because I know it's working. Okay, found my projector. Count is greater than one. Cool. Go here. Why am I down here? We crashed, that's why I'm down here. I didn't crash. What's going on? Is it like the reload mechanic not working properly? It should, I think it is. Okay, there we go. Cube. Warning range for some reason is not correct. Action range is not correct. So that's why this isn't working. So we forgot to get the projector's position, is what happened. So I need a pause equals projector. Okay, there's no actual easy button on this, so we're just gonna have to make an easy button. So this needs to be a vector 3. Okay. That should fix. Still not dead. Doing all this to kill pigs, and I kind of feel bad about this. Our position data is better, though. It looks nice. Still size of 0 though. Okay, so our position is the same in both directions. Okay, that's why. So what did we screw up down at the bottom here? Neg, pause, neg, start, end, pause, scale. Added translation to both. Okay, so we've got to debug this down here, is what's going to have to happen. Okay, so 3, 3, okay, I need to multiply. So literally just scale. Old system is weird. I think when Calclavia made the vector 3D system, he entirely based it off of Unity, and Unity's version of multiplication is literally called scale. Okay, hit play. That's not what I wanted to do. Hold on. This is gonna actually, it'll work, but it's not gonna work the way it's supposed to. Okay. Yeah, that looks about right. Height's about correct. We got a difference in height there. Um, That's a difference of 6 there. That shouldn't be 6. It probably should be like 7. Also got a distance. So these are both 6. These are both 6. I don't know why this, for some reason, is only a distance of 4. Translation is 6 up, so that's correct. Position, good. Okay, this all looks good. Piggies are still alive. Let me check what the corner is on here. 78 should be the top limit. I believe we saw 78, so that's good. Okay. Scanning through this, scanning. The warning range is smaller than the action range. I don't know what happened there. Figure it out in a second. See if it finds any entities. It found something. So let's go to debug list, and I want to see what you found. You found a piggy. We are not within range. So I need to borrow this piece of code. Boolean infilled equals. This would be infilled. And we'll do our code line here. I need to go check to see why the action range and warning range are so different from each other. It's probably the expand method. I didn't code it right. Yeah, right here. This would be a problem. That should be an add. Okay, now I should be able to hit play. We don't want this anymore. Okay, I have 5 entities in the field. It is not inside the projector field, which means that contains this vector 3D is not working properly. Actually, I know this isn't working properly. This is retarded. This is going to be the set of blocks that are actually the force field blocks themselves. We need a separate method to see if we are inside of the force field. I don't know if there's a way to do this. I mean, there's definitely something that calculates the shape. But I would have to figure it out. There should be a modular. It should be something that tells it what the projection of the force field looks like. I believe that modular also tells it what the inside blocks are. Fields to be projected, which is calculated up here, so that's calculated fields. So calculated fields, how are you made? What makes you? Okay, that's calculated field blocks. Get interior points is what I'm looking for. Yes. This is not cached. This is just gonna... Performance sucks so much. I'll have to cache it later. We'll focus on functionality now, and then we'll focus on lag later. So that means we want to call this get interior points, and then we want to floor this. This will give us a more precise check. We'll see what happens here. Hit play. Warning, you're in the scanning range. So it found me. It's inside the field. It's not within the range. So we want this. Is within is not running properly, and we'll have to fix it later. You know what reason why is within is not working properly? I'm retarded. I need this. Entity.posX, entity.posY, and then entity.posC. And then we can do the and thing here, because that within check should actually work. But the reason I keep saying it may not work is because I have literally not used it. I don't know how long, but it should work. Okay, this is running again. Next line. Next line. Why are you, what? Reload. Okay. Why is this line not letting me run? So we get down here. I want to see what the anti-fit, what? I want to see what this is doing, pretty much. Apparently I'm going to have to put a separate debug line here. Okay. Pig. Pig. Kill. Pig. Dead. That's not needed. We've pretty much fixed the system. Dead pigs. Okay. Call this in the video. I'll be back with more videos. Man, that was 2 hours. Damn. Be back later.